Hello young friends, a warm welcome to all of you to this BISEC program. I am here to speak on Restoration Comedy as well as Restoration Comedy. I am Jagdish Anerao and with me is Professor Shruti Kikani who hails from Khed Brahma. Actually, this topic, the Restoration Comedy and Restoration Tragedy, has been prescribed at various level of our syllabus. So we would first talk about what exactly is restoration, number one. Number two, what is restoration comedy and how we should talk about that. And third, the restoration tragedy. And we would relate the topics with special reference to Bonamy Daubry's book. So first of all, let us go to the restoration comedy. You can see in the slide that restoration comedy has some historical viewpoint also. Actually, restoration, the term in terms of literature, is very significant simply because there was a very important historical event which took place in the year of 1660. Most of us know, as a student of literature, that the King Charles II was restored to power in England, and the roots of this go back to the year 1642, when there was a revolution and Oliver Cromwell took over the powers. The king was dethroned, and that is why we call it restoration, when the king was brought back to power. So King Charles I was dethroned and he was axed, as you know, in the Tower of London, and that is why there was no king for as many as 18 years. What the Puritan government of Cromwell did was he banned all types of play-going activity. So there was no drama during these years. There were curbs and restrictions and bans on the play-going activity, playwriting also. There were no performances at all. In short, there were no entertaining events or activity during the Puritan regime in England. So restoration means the bringing back of the king to the power, to the monarchy. So monarchy was restored, and that is why we call it restoration. Wonderfully, what happened during the 18 years of Cromwell's rule was totally rejected by the Restoration Society, because they had no entertaining activities. So what they preferred was comedy. So restoration comedy is a landmark term in the history of English literature. Restoration is also known for the comedies. Several points to be noted are given in the slide, and my colleague Shruti would tell more about that. What exactly restoration comedy is and which are the features. So you can see again in the slide.
Yes, hello friends. As it is told to you earlier by Professor Arnera, I am going to talk about the restoration comedy, and then he will talk about the restoration tragedy. With the return of Charles II in 1660, the monarchy was re-established in England. And so this period is called as restoration period. The period was marked with restoration drama. Restoration comedy particularly, or comedy of manners, it developed and flourished in this period. And the theatres, as he told, they reopened with the permission of Charles II. Next.
The important thing to be noted in restoration comedy is complete French influence on the drama. The reason for this is when the King Charles I was dethroned, his family had to flee to France for survival, and King was axed, he was brutally killed by the Puritan government. At that time, the Prince Charles II was very young. So a young prince in France, which is known for fashionable people and fashionable style of living, he spent as many as 18 years in France. So he was totally familiar with the French drama and French way of life. And this is exactly what he meant for drama. So when he came back to power in England in 1660, he encouraged the French model of drama in England. naturally and obviously the king would not go for tragedies, so he encouraged comedies, and all the comedies therefore were based on the French models. And remarkable thing in the French model was that they were full of immorality, they were full of vulgarity, they were full of profaneness, they were full of sexuality. So the first thing we should remember about the Restoration comedy is that they are largely immoral, they are largely vulgar in terms of their presentation. Next very important aspect is the king himself was the patron of this type of comedies. So there was no questioning against this type of comedies. And his courtiers were the part of the audience. In a way, you can say, and this is what exactly we find in the book of Bonamy Daubry, that the audience comprised exclusively of the high society. So courtiers and the aristocrat class of England was the audience of this type of comedy. Again, if you go to the slide, you will see that in the slide you can see that Charles II was the active and interested patron of the drama. And soon after his restoration in 1660, he granted exclusive play going and play staging rights. This is very important because earlier for 18 years there were no drama activity. But because Charles II had been in France for several years, he was more interested in the drama, especially comedy, especially they were marked by vulgarity. So he gave rights, and that is known as royal patents, that is written in the slide you can see. And two companies came up. Remember, this is because there were no companies during the Puritan age of Oliver Cromwell. So the King's Company and the Duke's Company. So these were the two major companies which were given rights to perform and the drama. So in the next slide we can say some of the features are given which I think we all of us should note down, precisely because they are most outstanding features and which you seldom find these features in other type of comedies. Shruti will tell more about that.
Yeah, and these Restoration comedies, the setting was London, and particularly French influence was the influence of fine drama written by Molière, the relationship between man and women of sophisticated upper class society, and their love intrigues were the major themes of Restoration comedy. And next.
Yes, love intrigues is the key point in Restoration comedies, precisely because, as you know, youngsters and the aristocrat class, they are precisely interested in love making and affairs, and that was a kind of fashion among them. So love intrigues was the key feature of the Restoration comedies. Bonamy Daubry highlights this aspect in his book, and he talks about that because of the love intrigues, the plays were highly complicated, they were marked by artificiality also. That is why Daubry also calls this type of drama as artificial drama. And this is precisely because of the French influence, which is quite evident in the plays. Important thing regarding this comedies is it has got London setting. Earlier plays, you can go back to Shakespeare also, you will find very few plays have this setting. But because the king was the patron and he encouraged the urban society, that is why he encouraged most plays with the London setting only. And it was very much familiar to most of them. So they would not cherish any other setting, maybe in the forest, maybe on the riverside, maybe in other countries also. So most plays which were written during the Restoration age were having exclusively London setting. One more thing, the characters had got little significance. Then we would have the question, then what if not the characters? Then you can see that it has got witty dialogues. And in the next slide you can see that witty dialogues were having obscenity. Why? Then the reason is given in the slide, that the dialogues were vulgar and coarse simply because of they had double meanings. This is exactly what the King Charles encouraged. This is exactly what the audience, the upper class society and aristocratic class people demanded. So what happened was that, number one, audience was restricted, audience was limited to only a specific class of society, and number two, the dialogues were marked by vulgarity because of double meanings. And this is very negative side of English drama. This type of feature you never find in any other comedies of English literature, but this is exclusively true when we come across the Restoration comedies, and this is what most critics, most people disapproved. Dobry also disapproves this type of comedy simply because of its loose kind of things in terms of dialogues. They were highly immoral, they were highly vulgar, and double meaning in literature no one would certainly approve of. So next thing you can see, plots and characters are subordinated to witty dialogues and witty dialogues and clever exchange of repartee. This is very important. For example, because the society was well familiar with the plays of Shakespeare where the heroes and heroines were highlighted, they dominated the plays, and we call, for example, King Lear or Othello. What is that? So they were highlighted because of, and we know them, the plays, I mean, because of the titles, and the titles have come from the names of the heroes. This is exactly what we never find in any of the Restoration comedies. The reason is that what was prominent in the Restoration comedies was not, number one, character, was not plot. What was important was witty dialogues. Because of witty dialogues in this type of plays, they also call this type of comedies as intellectual comedies. Simply because when we think of wit, automatically we refer to intellect, and that is why most dramatists had to apply their intelligence, they had to apply their intellect just to make the show very powerful, very appealing, especially to the king and the audience. So what they encouraged, what they expected, what they demanded was not the character but witty dialogues with double meanings, which exclusively led to vulgarity, immorality and obscenity. And this is precisely what was a major concern for the society. Most critics, including Dobry, criticized this type of aspect of Restoration comedy, and especially when it is English comedy, then no one would certainly approve. If it is French comedy, then there was no question, but simply because it is the British comedy, it is English comedy, it is English literature, the critics were highly critical of this type of feature in the Restoration comedies. One more point to be noted. I told you earlier that Restoration comedy means only a limited class audience, that is highly sophisticated class, highly dominating class and aristocratic class. Most of them were courtiers of the king, and so the stage was only the king's court. There were no play going activity, there were no performances outside the court. So what happened was, a limited class of society only could have easy access to the Restoration comedies. It meant that most part of English society was intentionally kept away of the Restoration comedies. They didn't knew what the comedy is and how the comedies have been performed in the king's court. So what happened was that everyone was rather curious, number one, they were eager to know what is happening, number two, and number three, they also felt that why we are left out of this sphere of theater going, why there are no theaters, why there are no performances for us. And with this, we come to know what happened next was that because the middle class was left out, because the lower middle class was also left out of the theater going activity, they also felt we also belong and we can also belong to that class. And this type of attitude, highlighting the middle class morality, gave rise to new kind of comedy about which I would talk just within a few minutes. But I would like to point out one important point, that Restoration Comedy was restricted to the upper class only because of, number one, the king himself was the patron. Number two, lower class or middle class could not afford to pay the handsome amount and rewards to the actors. What they demanded was only money, and it was king and his courtiers who could afford to give them handsome amount for their performances. If they get, for example, 100 rupees from the king, the ordinary man hardly would spare 10 rupees, and no play writer or no actor would prefer that amount. So this is why the middle class or the lower classes were totally kept out of the sphere of the Restoration comedies, and it was only restricted or limited to the upper class society. And king also encouraged this type of activity. There was no questioning against him because he himself was the highest authority and the final authority. So what we can say is, number one, when we think of Restoration comedy, it is marked by French influence. Number two, it has got restricted or limited audience, that is comprised of aristocratic class society, upper class society. Number three, only London setting, no rural side settings, no outside England settings, exclusively England setting. And number four, because of the French influence, most Restoration comedies were marked by immorality, vulgarity, obscenity. And this is exactly what the people, the audience demanded. And that is why it was largely disapproved by society in general, who were not part of the audience, but they could know what is happening in the comedies, which were encouraged and patronized by the king himself. So, if we go to the next slide, as Shruti told you, that the plays are known as the comedy of manners. The reason is very important. They are known as comedy of manners simply because they